In the cold, grey waters of the Baltic Sea, a ghost moves silently between the islands. Undetectable, untraceable, and deadly. Angular, faceless, and radar-evading, Sweden's Visby-class corvette is a hunter-killer ghost, designed to strike with precision and vanish before an enemy even knows it was there. When the Visby appears on the radar, it's already too late. At first glance, the Visby class may appear compact, but its dimensions are finely tuned for maneuverability in shallow, island-strewn waters. Each vessel measures approximately 239 feet in length, with a beam of 34 feet and a draft of just 8 feet. This shallow draft is critical for operating in Sweden's coastal archipelagos, allowing the ship to navigate close to shorelines and evade detection in tight littoral zones. With a displacement of around 640 tons, the Visby class is lightweight for a warship of its capability, thanks largely to its pioneering use of carbon fiber reinforced plastic in the hull and superstructure. This composite material offers significant benefits. It reduces the ship's radar and infrared signature, enhances corrosion resistance in salty environments, and contributes to the overall stealth profile that is central to its design. Stealth is the very foundation of the Visby class. The entire external geometry is designed to minimize radar cross-section using angled surfaces, smooth joints, and integrated masts. The CFRP construction also drastically reduces the ship's magnetic signature, making it less vulnerable to magnetically triggered mines. Infrared suppression systems further reduce the thermal footprint, allowing the Visby to approach undetected, strike, and disengage with minimal exposure. Built to operate undetected, the Visby-class corvette doesn't just rely on stealth to survive. It is equipped with a cutting-edge arsenal and a suite of advanced sensors that allow it to detect, track, and strike with precision long before an adversary knows it's there. The Visby class was conceived as a true multi-role combatant, and its modular architecture reflects that ambition. While the initial vessels were commissioned without full armament, part of a phased integration strategy, the class is now equipped or prepared to field a potent mix of weapons suited for surface warfare, anti-submarine warfare, and mine countermeasures. At the heart of the Visby-class corvette's offensive punch lies the RBS 15 Mark III, a long-range, all-weather, fire-and-forget anti-ship missile system that transforms the stealthy corvette into a genuine standoff strike platform. Developed jointly by Saab Bosphorus Dynamics and Diehl Defence, the Mark III is the latest evolution of the widely respected RBS series, and one of the most advanced missile systems in its class deployed by any navy today. The RBS 15 Mark III boasts a range exceeding 124 miles, allowing the Visby to engage enemy warships well beyond visual or radar horizon. This gives Swedish naval commanders a decisive tactical advantage, the ability to neutralize high-value targets before being detected, leveraging the corvette's stealth and sensor fusion capabilities. Unlike many anti-ship missiles, the Mark III is also land attack capable, giving the Visby class the flexibility to strike coastal infrastructure, command centers, or logistics hubs. This dual-mode function adds significant operational value, especially in the Baltic Sea, where key targets are often located close to the shoreline. The RBS 15 Mark III carries a 200-kilogram high-explosive blast and fragmentation warhead, capable of crippling or sinking large warships with a single hit. It also features advanced countermeasure capabilities, allowing it to resist jamming, decoys, and electronic interference, essential features in the electronic warfare-heavy environments of Northern Europe. On the Visby-class corvettes, the missiles are housed in stealth-compatible vertical launch canisters, concealed beneath deck-level hatches to maintain the vessel's low radar profile. When needed, the covers open and the missiles are fired in quick succession, often in coordinated salvos, paired with radar or satellite targeting data for maximum effectiveness. Forward on the deck sits the Bosphorus 57mm Mark III naval gun, a rapid-firing, multi-purpose weapon capable of engaging surface, air, and shore targets. With a firing rate of up to 220 rounds per minute and programmable ammunition, it provides versatile firepower for a range of combat scenarios, from swarming attack boats to low-flying drones. For subsurface threats, the Visby class can be equipped with TP-45 or TP-47 lightweight torpedoes launched from twin 400mm torpedo tubes. These torpedoes are optimized for shallow water engagements, precisely the kind of threat environment Sweden faces in the Baltic. Coupled with the ship's sonar and towed array systems, the Visby can actively hunt submarines with stealth and lethality. In addition to traditional combat roles, several Visby-class vessels are outfitted with MCM capabilities. These include remotely operated vehicles and mine detection sonar, making the corvette uniquely versatile among its peers. The Visby-class corvette sends a strong message. Sweden is not a passive maritime actor. While modest in size compared to major fleets, the Visby's capabilities, particularly its ability to strike undetected and vanish before retaliation, create uncertainty in the mind of any potential aggressor. It is this uncertainty that forms the cornerstone of deterrence in Sweden's modern naval doctrine. In the murky depths of the Pacific in 2005, a quiet yet extraordinary event played out beneath the surface. A maritime Goliath, the recently commissioned $6.2 billion behemoth USS Ronald Reagan, was pitted against an unlikely adversary. This was not an enemy battleship, but an elusive phantom of the deep, the Swedish submarine HSWMS Gotland. The Gotland silently and stealthily maneuvered into the perfect position for a strike. An eerie quiet filled the moment, and then reality buckled. The mighty Reagan was sunk. The naval world watched, not in horror, but in a mix of shock and awe. Even though this was a simulation, it also served as a stark wake-up call from the deep. Under the deceptive tranquility of the exercise, a sense of astonishment persisted. How could this modest submarine have achieved such a seemingly impossible feat? Sweden, having operated submarines in the Baltic since 1904, has a distinguished history in underwater warfare. In this brackish sea, often referred to as a flooded meadow with an average depth of just 200 feet, it has honed its naval defense strategy. Their prized asset is the Gotland-class submarine, a unique and quiet warrior tailor-made for these shallow depths, where the larger, nuclear-powered submarines of Russia and the US dare not tread. Staying out for weeks on end is not a design parameter. They're very rarely far from a home port. However, they're very rarely far from the enemy either. The Gotland-class submarines are far from traditional diesel-electric boats. They were the world's first submarines to feature a Stirling engine air-independent propulsion, or AIP, system, a technological marvel that revolutionized underwater endurance. This system, usually exclusive to nuclear-powered submarines, allows these submarines to stay submerged for weeks. Traditional diesel subs surface every few days to recharge batteries, but the Gotland-class preserves battery life for speed, cruising on AIP. The AIP system, in essence, involves storing liquid oxygen, or LOX, on board for running a diesel engine while submerged, a sophisticated process carefully engineered to not endanger the crew. The LOX, combined with an inert gas like argon, is sent to the engines. The exhaust gases are cooled and scrubbed to extract any remaining oxygen and argon, then mixed with seawater and expelled. The extracted argon is mixed with oxygen and recirculated to the diesel engine. This groundbreaking AIP system significantly increases a diesel-electric submarine's underwater endurance. It enables them to stay submerged for weeks without surfacing, offering a stealthy, cost-effective, and deadly silence when cruising underwater at low speeds. Gotland-class submarines can also operate as traditional diesel electrics, surfacing to run on standard diesel engines or operating solely on battery power, reaching submerged speeds of up to 20 knots. This versatile operational capacity provides the Gotland-class with tactical agility that is difficult for the enemy to predict. Various other traits improve stealth and evasion. The Gotland-class has 27 electromagnets to counteract magnetic signatures, a sonar-resistant hull coating, a radar-absorbent tower, and rubber acoustic-deadening buffers to minimize sonar detection. Measuring 200 feet in length and just over 20 feet in width, the Gotland-class carries a lean crew of 24 rigorously tested sailors and officers. Its weaponry includes four 533mm torpedo tubes that can fire heavy-hitting Bosphor's underwater systems Type 613 torpedoes and a pair of 400mm tubes that can hold two Saab Bosphor's underwater systems Type 32X2 lightweight multi-role torpedoes each. Their state-of-the-art combat management system can guide multiple torpedoes during a single attack. Coupled with its sensor suite by Atlas Electronic, including sonar arrays, electronic service measures, and Thales radar detection, classification and homing missile suite called Manta, the Gotland-class is a formidable player in undersea warfare. In addition to all these capabilities, the Gotland-class excels in mine warfare. It can deploy autonomous, self-propelled Mine 42, capable of lying in wait for a target to pass by, or carry up to 48 traditional mines externally. This combination of attributes has resulted in an impressive underwater combatant that's nimble and unpredictable. The Gotland-class's unique X-shaped tail plane, along with its automated control system, enables tight maneuvers even in confined shallow waters. Due to its size, automation, and maneuverability, the Gotland-class is often described as the F-16 Viper of undersea combat. This concludes our episode on the Swedish Navy's ghost ships. So what do you think about these remarkable combatants? What other pieces of military hardware would you like us to cover in our future episodes? Also, if you were lucky to see these ships up close, or better yet, served as a crew member, please comment. Remember to hit the subscribe button and ring that bell to stay updated with our latest content. And while you're here, why not check out another one of our exciting videos? Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.